Ever wondered how to translate in SDL Trados? Coming up. Hello and welcome back to the Freelanceverse. A few months ago, I made a video on MemoQ, how to translate in MemoQ. It has been received very well and people were asking for a part two and also for other CAT tools. And for some reason, I haven't been able to make another video on this. So today is the long-awaited video, how to translate in SDL Trados. The tool is still called SDL Trados, I just checked, even though SDL has been acquired by RWS. I don't know if you've heard of this news a few months back. There was a huge acquisition in the language industry. I don't know if they will eventually change the name of the tool. It's definitely the most used and most widespread CAT tool in the world. A lot of agencies require you to work with that. I do work with it as well, almost on a daily basis, but only when agencies or when clients send me packages and I work in it. If I start a project on my own, I always work in MemoQ. But it's still good to have a license. It's a bit expensive, but for me, it definitely pays off because I get a lot of Trados projects to translate in there. So let's skip to the screen view and I will walk you through the basics of how to translate in Trados. Hope you enjoy. So it turns out I was wrong in the intro and it's actually not called SDL anymore. At least the new version is not, because I'm on my new PC, so I had to reinstall SDL Trados, or Trados Studio, how it's called now. The 2019 version that I have is still called SDL Trados, but if you would install the 2021 version, the newest one, it's just called Trados Studio. But it would cost me like €300 to upgrade, and I don't need to upgrade. I work with this every day and all my clients work with this, so I stick with 2019. All right, so this is the main... Wait, this is all in German. Let me just change the language here. All right, that's better. Now you can actually follow. This is the main view of Trados. It looks very sleek, very simple. You see here a big square that I use mostly, drag files for translation or browse your computer. So if you just want to import a file and work with translate it in Trados, you can take the file, drag it on here, and it will basically start the whole process on its own. Now, actually, I said I use this a lot. I actually don't use this a lot, because when I do these translations that I just work from files, I work in MemoQ, as I said in the beginning. So I use Trados mainly or almost exclusively for projects that I get from clients. So either I get the Trados package that I need to import myself, then I would go to Open Project Package. Project packages, I think they have an ending PPX, if I'm not mistaken, when it comes in, and then you translate it and you export it, and it's an RPX, a return package. That's one option, or they can also send me the package right on their server, on the group share project, the group share server. Then it's called a group share project. So they never actually send me a file. They just send me a link. They say, hey, we would like you to translate this. It's on our server. Then I go to Open Trados group share project. I take the file directly from their server that I set up previously with a password for me personally. I translate it there and I check it back in. So I never actually have a physical file here. These two options I use most, and these are the three options that you would use frequently. So of course this should be a rather short video for the basics. So these three things we are going to explain. So let's start with the basics. Let's just translate a file. I prepared a little test file and I'm going to drag and drop it into this square here. Drop here for translation. This is a test. That's the name of the file that I named, that I created. Now you can create a project or you can translate as a single document. What this means, if you create a project, you can add a translation memory, you can add a glossary, etc. You can later on add additional documents as well. If you just translate it as a single document, you don't have these things. So I would always create a new project, because you never know what comes from this, right? You never know if you want to add to it. So let's do that, create new project. Then this window opens up. Does it recognize the languages? I don't know if it recognizes the languages or if it just chooses your preferred language, probably. For me, it's correct. It's English UK to German Switzerland. I give it a project name here. Let's just call it test. Here you can choose the location. And then down here, you should click the file that you want to translate. So it is currently not clicked, so you have to choose it. And it's translatable, that's good. It's in Word, so there shouldn't be a problem. It's all very basic. I click Next. In this dialogue, I never change anything. You could add a project description if you want to, but I never do that. Translation resources. Here you can add a translation memory if you don't have one yet, or if you don't have one from a client. I'm gonna add one for this. Let's act like this from a client that I will do several projects for. So I want to build a translation memory for this client. So I click on create. I name this Freelanceverse test. And I save it. I don't think you need to check it because it's already enabled here and lookup as well. So this means that everything you save in your project goes into the translation memory, and also lookup is activated, concordance is activated and update is activated. So you can actually look things up that you then saved in your memory. So later on, if I add more projects to this, I take the Freelanceverse translation memory, I will have all my glossaries in there. Term bases I'm not gonna add, but this is where you could add a term base if you have a glossary from a client, if they sent this with you, or if you have an industry-based term base, you can add it here. And yeah, I can click on finish. More is not to do. So you see it imports everything. I click on close, and now we have a project. Well, I'm gonna have to blur these. This is a list of all the projects that I worked with because I just reinstalled it. The list is very short, but usually this list is full of new projects. The test is the one that I created. So I double click on it to open it, and then we get to the file. So before it was the project overview, now we are in the file overview. You see it down here in the bottom left, actually. Now we are on files, right? In the editor is where you translate. In the project is where we were before. File is where we are now. Reports, you can go here and you see how many words the file has. You can see the whole breakdown. If, for example, if you work with an agency client, it's likely that they work with these repetitions, that you don't get paid fully if it's a repetition or a fuzzy match. And that's good to know here. That's the reports and the translation memories. But now we are on files, right? We see this is a test. It has 26 words. Now we can open it and we get into the editor. I mentioned in my cut tools video and my tier list that SDL Trados is quite slow for me because it's such a big project, such a big software, and that is still the case even though I have now a brand new computer. So yeah, I don't know, it is the biggest, it is the probably the most well-known and the best one, but it's very big and sometimes slow. This is the test file that I created. This is a test. I want to show my audience how to translate in SDL Trados. Please subscribe and like the video. This is a test. I specifically wrote this as a test twice so we can actually test the auto-propagate function. Theoretically, I should only have to translate this once, and then it should also create a follow down here, and you will see how it works. So if I already had a working translation memory installed, I have a working one, but it's empty, right? If there was only already stuff in there, it would come up here, term recognition, right? No, oh no, this is term base. Yeah, here is in the middle is the translation memory. So if there was already a match, it would tell me here what the match is, how many percentages, and I could use it if I wanted to. Now this is brand new, so there are no matches yet. Now this is a test. I translate this as "Das ist ein Test," and then Control Enter confirms the segment. When I do this, you see segment 4 is already 100% match. It is not complete. It is not immediately confirmed. You see, it's a blue pencil. That means it's in progress, right? It's not confirmed. It's a draft status, and a green pencil with a check mark is translated. You can set this that it immediately confirms it, but I don't want to do that because sometimes the auto propagation is too eager and you don't actually want it to be the same, right? The same word can be different in different contexts. So it's a good help that it suggests this to me, and most of the times I will just confirm it when it comes to it, but sometimes it's not accurate. But here it is. So once I'm here in the translation, of course this is a small document, but if this comes up 100 times, it's very helpful that this always gets auto-propagated, and I can just Control Enter and confirm it. Exactly. Let's do one more segment. Ich will meinen Zuschauerinnen und Zuschauern zeigen, wie man in SDL Trados übersetzt. Control Enter, and it's confirmed. Down here in the down right corner, you always see the progress. You see 23% are still empty, 76% are done. So if you're here, if you are at 100% here, you are done, right? This is a good indication when you have a big project, how far along you are. And once you're done, you can basically export the file. You can go on batch tasks and then export files, and you are done. You can send this to the client. Because if you do this without the package, then they probably didn't require you to work in Trados, so you can just send them a word back. That's basically the basics how to work in Trados. Now let's look at the packages, because that's a very different thing. Okay, now to the second version. I am unable to create a project package because I have a freelancer version. If you want to create packages, you have to have another version. So I just use an example package of a few years ago that I got from a client. So if there is sent me a package, a PPX, I need to translate it, export the return package, and send that back, right? So I don't get a file, I don't get a Word file per se, I get a Trados file. How I can do this is I can open project package, choose my package here, open it, and then you get the dialog box and you see how many words it is, 519, untranslated 463. So you finish it and it imports it, and then you're immediately in this files view. So you see it's 10% is already pre-translated, so you kind of know how long it will take you. And then when you open it, you can immediately start to translate, and also it has a translation memory attached because that's in the package, right? You don't need to do anything here. So it already suggests a few things like communiqué de presse is already presse mitteilung, because that's in the TM, right? If I click on here, you see it up here, number one, pre-translated. So you don't need to do anything. Yes, that's basically that. And then the third option is the Open Trados group share project. I can't give you an example here because there it really needs to be live, right? But if someone sends me an email and says, you would like you to translate this text, I add it to our servers. I can go here, choose a server of my clients. Well, I'm gonna blur all the servers that come up here, but I have all my client servers that I have a login for on here. And then when I choose one, and there is actually one available for me, then it will show up here and I can click on it, next, open it, and then I'm in the same view as before and I can start translating. There you go, these are the three versions. Just make sure you know what you are working with. If you do it yourself, if you import a Word or an Excel into Trados, you also deliver a Word Excel, you just click export, that's it. If they send you a Trados package, you import it, translate in here, export a return package, and you send that back. And if they send you a group share project, you work directly on their server, you translate, you check it back into the server, so you don't even need to send anything, right? It's all automated emails. These are the three versions how to work with Trados. I hope this was useful. I can always make a part two. This was just the basics, right? Same as with the MMOQ. Let me know which cut tool I should do next, and I see you next Monday with the next video. Bye bye.